Welcome back to Proactive. I'm joined on the line now by Anish Kapadia from Hannam Partners, and he's written a report all about Blue Star Helium. Anish, great to have you on the line.
Thanks, my pleasure to be here.
Great. Now, before we delve into Blue Star Helium, could you just start by giving us an overview of the helium market itself, please?
Sure. So the helium market is quite a niche market compared to other commodity markets. And what we've seen over the last year or so is considerable tightness from the supply side of helium. That's down to a number of factors. The biggest supply out of storage of helium, the US BLM, has been down for the majority of this year, and there's a risk that that might go down again. That's around 10 to 15% of global helium supply. Also, there's been impacts with, there's been expected production to come on from Russia. That was supposed to supply over time 30% of the world's helium market, and you know, clearly with the issues that are going on in Russia, that's not going to happen. So overall, we've seen a big supply impact on the helium market. Demand has remained fairly constant because a lot of industries that use helium are very price insensitive. It's a unique product that is essential to a number of industries. And as a result, we've seen pricing reach very, very high levels. To kind of give you some idea, you've had helium pricing over $1,000 per million cubic feet. Kind of to put that in context of natural gas, you know, we've been talking about high natural gas prices in Europe when they sky high prices, and they've been reaching $50 per thousand cubic feet.
So just how important a part of the Blue Star portfolio is helium?
So I'd say helium's the key driver of Blue Star. One of the interesting things with Blue Star is that it's a primary helium producer. The majority of helium globally is produced as a byproduct of natural gas, whereas Blue Star are looking to produce helium as a primary product. The reason they've got the ability to do that is the location they're in Colorado has some of the highest concentrations of helium that you'll have seen globally. You know, generally you've got sub 1% concentrations of helium. You know, they've shown evidence of helium concentrations closer to 10% on some of their wells. They're very shallow wells, so they're low cost to drill. You know, much lower than what you see again elsewhere, around the $500,000 mark. And they're in a location in the US, which accounts for around probably 50% of global helium demand. They've got the infrastructure in place. They've got the end markets in place, and it's one of the regions that's seen the highest levels of helium pricing this year.
Wow. So are they almost entirely producing in the US?
So they are, yeah, their sole focus is in Colorado in the US.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So could you tell us about the projects they've got underway there?
Yeah, so they have a number of leases in the Las Animas area of Colorado. They've actually drilled a number of exploratory wells into their acreage over the last year or so. Those wells have generally been successful. They've managed to flow helium to surface at attractive production rates. They've had high concentrations of helium, as I mentioned earlier, ranging up to around 8-9%. They've actually been able on the back of that to book contingent resource. They've had from a reserve auditor, and they've got a considerable amount of prospective resource, which we'd expect to flow into contingent resource and eventually into 2P discovered resource.
So how well funded are they for all these operations?
Given the low cost of the wells, they've got the ability to drill several more exploration wells to delineate their acreage, and also drill a few development wells to actually start some initial production. They will need some financing to proceed with development. You know, we see the first facility coming on stream early in the second half of next year, so it's quite quick to development. But there's also the potential to debt finance some of these projects. There's the ability to sign long-term fixed price contracts for helium, especially given the state of the current market. So the financing need, I think, will be pretty reasonable. And they've also got the opportunity to tap the equity markets. They've been quite successful in the past in tapping the equity markets when needed.
Now, in terms of the longer term outlook, do they have much more exploring to do?
Yeah, so they've got a large acreage position. I'd say they've only scraped the surface in terms of what they have in their region. They're in the process of permitting up to, you know, to over 50 wells. So that kind of gives you some idea of the scale of the acreage. So I think it's very much a combination of further exploration to prove up more resource, as well as then developing what they've found already. And I think they've got the potential to be a major supplier globally of helium.
Now, moving on from helium, anybody that's tried to buy any dry ice recently will know that there are very high prices currently payable for CO2. So is CO2 something that Blue Star are looking at?
So yes, the CO2 market's quite interesting at the moment. You've had shortages. We've seen it in Europe as again, CO2 is a byproduct. So when some of those plants shut down, you lose the CO2. Similar things happened in the US, as well as they've had some issues with existing CO2 production facilities. So there's a major shortage of CO2 in the market at the moment. That's created pretty high pricing for CO2. And there's also the opportunity, if you've got CO2, to sequester that CO2 and get CO2 credits from under the new IRA Act from the US. So the CO2 market's quite interesting. Within a number of Blue Star's wells, they've had some CO2 content to relatively high CO2 content. So they're investigating the potential to put a CO2 processing plant on alongside the helium processing plant, and that could add a further stream of revenues. I'd say it's kind of the cherry on top of the helium, which in itself is highly economic.
Speaking of revenue streams, just finally, how well positioned do you feel like Blue Star are financially heading into the next, say, 6 months?
As I was saying earlier, I think they're fairly well financed for their exploration campaign over the coming months. When we look at it on valuation, our valuation implies on our risked NAV, where we're quite conservative in terms of what's developed. In terms of our helium price, we're using a $450 per MCF helium price, much lower than what I was talking about in terms of spot pricing being well over $1,000 per MCF in the US. We come up with around 300% upside to our risked NAV at the current share price for Blue Star. On an unrisked basis, you've got well over 10x upside for Blue Star. So I think the company looks quite attractive in absolute terms, but also relative to the market, in that it has a higher helium concentration than a lot of its peers. It's got a lower cost base than many of its peers. It's more advanced in terms of the amount of exploration that it's done. It's in a low cost jurisdiction. It's in a low tax jurisdiction, and it's helium is a critical mineral in North America. So I see Blue Star as very, very strongly positioned.
Very strongly positioned indeed. Well, thank you very much for giving us all the details on Blue Star Helium. Anish Kapadia from Hannam Partners.
Thank you very much.